income from discontinued operations. There are number of companies in which some kind of incomes is also there from discontinued operation. For example, some operations are treated as discontinued operation. For example, if you have a 4 units in the organization, one unit is discontinued, but still from that discontinued operation, some income or revenue is pouring in the organization and some expenditure is also met. So in order to discreate the confusion or remove the confusion, we want to tell to the stakeholder that this is an income which is from the discontinued operation. Usually in case of discontinued operation, the losses are more than the income. Revenues are lesser and the costs are more because there are certain kind of fixed costs that needs to be incurred. But because the operations are discontinued now, we don't have the variable expenses. So only fixed part of expenses are there, and that there is lesser revenue because the operations of the business are discontinued. So therefore, it is very important to tell to the stakeholders or to the external parties which are dealing with the business, so that in income statement, these are the portion of income from continued operation, and this is the portion of income from the discontinued operation. That is the subject matter which we will discuss today. So let's come straightway to the presentation. So today's presentation will be focusing on external financial reporting of single entities, income statement and discontinued operation. So here we will be focusing on what do you mean by the external financial reporting for single entities, how the income statement reflect the income or loss from the discontinued operation, what do you mean by the discontinued operation. In detail we will be discussing all these things. So under understanding external financial reporting is very, very important from all of us point of view. Basically, external financial reporting is a business practice that involves providing financial information on periodic basis to investors and shareholders, who are the parties not internal to the organization. They are not employees, they are not our managers, they are not our executives. So they have made investment, either as a potential investment they want to invest, either they are present investors who are known as shareholders. So the reports are primarily financial statements and other related information about the company that investor is required to make an investment decision. Usually the reports do not contain confidential information about the company unless it is disclosed to achieve a specific purpose. So basically, external financial reporting is that kind of practice where we provide financial information on periodic basis to the people who are intended to become the shareholder, that is prospective investors, or the people who has already invested in the shares of the company, they are known as the shareholders. So these kind of reports usually contain the financial statement, the 5 kind of financial statements which we prepare, that is statement of comprehensive income, statement of financial position, statement of changes in equity, and statement of cash flows, and lastly notes to the account. So these are the 5 external financial reports which we prepare, and usually these kind of information do not include confidential information. Disclosing the confidential information is necessary to achieve a specific kind of objective, then we include confidential information in the external.
Sir, screen show nahi ho rahi.
Okay. Let me check. Now is it visible?
Yes, sir. Okay. Thank you.
So we were talking about external financial reporting. So basically, external financial reporting are the financial reports which we usually prepare while preparing the financial statements of different organizations. So just one second. Secondly, we prepare the external financial report because the existing laws require public companies to publish a set of audited financial statement at the end of the financial year. But internal reports which are prepared, they are not required by any law. So it is done to meet the international requirements also, because the international financial reporting standards, different industries parties such as investors, analysts, regulator, as well as discharge the accountability duty to the organization. So we prepare these external financial reports because the law require it, or some standards require it, or some regulatory agencies require it to publish. Then the most important question before us is how to account for discontinued operation on an income statement, because our profit and loss account or the statement of comprehensive income, the statement of comprehensive income requires that these kind of information should be segregated into two different parts. One is income from continued operation or income from discontinued operation, so that the users or the stakeholders can know that whether any part of income is there which is from the discontinued operation and which will not be in future. So for taking the decisions on their own, whether to invest into that company or not to invest into that company, that information is required. So company's income statement summarizes various things. Number one, they summarize the revenue, they summarize the expenses, profits for an accounting period. So discontinued operation is a separate major business decision or geographical operation that the company has to has already disposed of, either or either it is holding for sale. So we have to disclose the results from discontinued operation on an income statement or in accompanying notes. The two components of the disclosures are profits or loss from the discontinued operation and the gain or loss from a disposal. So two things need to be disclosed in the income statement. Number one, profit or loss from the discontinued operation, because some revenue activities may be going on, because in order to dispose of any business or to discontinue any business operation, it takes time. During that period, you may have earned certain revenue, you may have certain incurred some expenditure. So that needs to be disclosed separately. But when it is disposed of, you may have gain or you may have loss. So you have to segregate what is the profit or loss from the discontinued operation, if it is still continuing because it needs some time to actually close it down, or if it is sold out, then separately you have to tell it what is the gain or loss from such kind of disposal. So in comprehensive income statement, you have to disclose these two components separately. Secondly, you have to create a separate section in the comprehensive income statement, which will be titled as discontinued operation on in the income statement. And this should come after the continuous operation. First of all, you must disclose the profit from continued operation, and then you must disclose the profits or loss from discontinued operations. Meaning below the net income from continued operations line, you have to after that explain. So this line in this section may include gain or loss from discontinued operation, including disposal. So income tax benefit or expense and the tax adjusted gain or loss from discontinued operation, if it is there, that is need to be disclosed. So we have to calculate the profit or loss from discontinued operation, which is equal to revenue minus expenses. So revenue will include products and service sales minus sales return and allowances. Expenses include operating expenses such as marketing and administration, non-operating expenses, etc., such as interest, taxes, and unusual items. So show these calculations in the notes accompanying the income statement. It is not required that you must detail them in the income statement itself. You must focus in the notes to the account. So firstly, you have to calculate separately the income, profit or loss from the discontinued operation, which will be equal to revenue minus expenses, and detailing of the revenues, including product and sales services, sales return, allowances, expenses, including operating expenses such as marketing and administration and non-operating expenses such as interest, taxes and usual. You may show these in the notes to the account, but in aggregate form, you may show it in the comprehensive income statement. Similarly, you have to explain if it is any gain or loss is there from the disposal of such assets. So you must disclose it separately. That will be the amount received minus expended. So in this way, the discontinued operation component of comprehensive income statement should be explained in such a manner the aggregate figures in the comprehensive income statement and the detailing in the notes to the accounts. So in this way, we have to find out the gain or loss from the disposition or discontinued operation only if the disposal occurred during the accounting period. That gain or loss will be the difference between selling price and the fair market value. We have already discussed in the last lecture that how to find out the fair market value of the assets which are held for sale because of the discontinued operation. So if any selling price is attained during the accounting period minus all fair value cost and minus transaction costs which are occurred because to sell or dispose of these assets. So if any profit or loss from the discontinued operation is there, that is added to the gain or loss on the disposal, and they record this amount next to the gain or losses from the discontinued operation, including disposal line. So we have to calculate tax adjusted gain or loss from the discontinued operation. If any tax has been paid, that you will decrease your income. If the lesser taxes are there, that is going to, if the loss is there, that is going to decrease your taxes. So there are two kinds of reporting, as I have already said to you, that there is one which is known as internal reporting and second which is known as external reporting. And basically, internal versus external financial reporting has several key differences that you should be aware of. Internal financial reporting is a business practice that involves compiling information on a frequent basis for use within the organization. For example, you calculate ratio analysis. You calculate various ratios to arrive at various logical decisions. Some cost figures may be have been calculated, marginal cost items may be there. So documents may contain confidential information which you don't want to disclose to others, such as business indicators, financial performance, performance indicators, etc. So they are designed to help those individuals working within the organization to make informed decisions. But as far as the external financial reporting is concerned, this is usually made to disclose something to the outside parties or the parties which are either prospective investors or our already shareholders, so that they can take logical decisions on the basis of that. So that information also includes the information regarding the discontinued operation. So if you don't disclose the information regarding the discontinued operation, this will create a confusion in the minds of the people that the total profit which is attained, that is from the continued operations, and in future also this profit will continue. But if you explain it differently in two components, income from continued operation and income from discontinued operation also, then it will give the reflection in the minds of the other people that the income or loss from the discontinued operation may not be there in the future. So therefore, whether their investment is safe in the organization or whether their investment is unsafe in the organization. So therefore, external financial reporting is very important to disclose income from discontinued operations. And it involves financial information to be distributed to the outside parties. Unlike internal reports, external reports do not contain confidential information about the companies. So here I can define, because we have already defined in the last lecture, what are the discontinued operation. So discontinued operation refers to the part of the company's core business or product line that have been divested or shut down, and there are reported separately from the continued operation in the income statement. For example, you must have heard about it that these days the car manufacturing companies are shutting down their shutters for all cars which were not BS6 compatible. So naturally, the diesel version of the smaller cars are going to be shut down. So naturally, these are the discontinued operations. But still, they are earning some kind of income because it takes a long gestation period, because you have to provide after-sales services for these the cars which are already been sold. So therefore, for some time, these discontinued operations will continue and some revenues may be pouring in the organization. And after a period of time, you will sell it out, you will dispose it out, some profit or gain may be there. So these needs to be disclosed to the outsider parties, that is the external reporting segment, so that the people can know what kind of income they are earning from discontinued operation or what kind of income they are earning from the continued operations. So discontinued operations are listed separately in the income statement, because it is very important that investor can clearly distinguish the profits and cash flows from continued operation from those activities that have ceased. This distinction is especially useful when companies merge as a passing out which assets are being divested or folded, give a clear picture of how a company will make money in the future. That's why it is very important for the stakeholders to the know about these kind of figures. So on a company's income statement, in discontinued operations are segregated from the continued operations so that the investors may clearly what money is inflowing from current operations versus those which have ceased, because it is their right to know all about it. So there are certain disclosures which needs to be made as per the IFRS 5 also, or as per the IFRS of other nature. When operations are discontinued, a company has a multiple line items to report in its financial statement. Although the business component is being shut down, it still could generate a gain or loss in the accounting period. That needs to be disclosed. The total gain or loss from the discontinued operation is thus reported, followed by the relevant income taxes. That tax is often a future tax benefit, because discontinued operation often incur losses. To determine the company's total net income, the gain or loss from the discontinued operation is aggregated with the continued operation. So that's why it needs to be disclosed. So as to not to confuse the adjustment to the financial statement that relates to the previously reported discontinued operation, a company may classify the adjustment separately in the discontinued operation section of its financials. Adjustment may occur because of the benefit plan obligation, contingent liabilities, or contingent contract terms. If a buyer of a discontinued operation assumed the debt assumed with the operation, any interest expense before the sale is allocated to the discontinued operation. So generally accepted accounting principle do not allow general corporate overhead to be allocated to the discontinued operation. But as far as the IFRSs are concerned, they allow to do so. So there are key takeaways. Number one, discontinued operation is an accounting term that refers to the part of company's core business or a product line that have been divested or shut down. First, you must know. Secondly, discontinued operations are reported on income statements separately from continued operation. Number three, number four, when companies merge, understanding which assets are being divested can give a clear picture of how a company will make money in the future. So discontinued operation under GAAP, so under generally accepted accounting principle, which the earlier practices we were doing, a company may report discontinued operation under GAAP as long as two conditions are met. Number one, first, the transaction to shut down the divested business will result in eliminating the operations and cash flows of the divested business from a company operation. Secondly, once it is discontinued, the closed business must have no significant ongoing investment with its operations. If these two conditions are met, then a company may report discontinued operation on its financial statement. This was under the GAAP. But as far as the IFRS is concerned, if any discontinued operation is there, if any revenue is generated, if any expenditures are made on that, if any gain or loss from the disposal of such assets is going to occur, that you must report in the comprehensive income statement, and its detailing must be explained in the notes to the accounts. So, but under IFRS, reporting rules differ from the GAAP. A discontinued operation must meet two criteria. First, the asset or business must be component, must be disposed of, reporting as held for sale. Second, the component must be distinguishable as a separate business that is being removed from the operational and efficiency or a subsidiary of the component intent to sell. So therefore, if these two conditions, that means if the business is discontinued, asset is held for sale, non-current is there, and then any revenue or expenditures are incurred or any profit or gain is going to held from that kind of activity, that you must report separate line as income or profit or gain from discontinued operation. So this was just a detailing of what we require to explain under the income statement, how to report the income from discontinued operation. This is the sum of all the various international financial reporting standards which we use to prepare the financial statements. So now you can on your videos so that we can have certain questions. Yes.
So सर
जी जी ऐश्वर्या
सर जो हमने इस कंटिन्यूएशन वाला जो चैप्टर सेक्शन पढ़ा था उसमें एक कैश फ्लो के साथ रिलेटेड लाइन थी पैराग्राफ था वो समझ में नहीं आया
कैश फ्लो दैट मींस कि बिकॉज ऑफ डिसकंटिन्यूड ऑपरेशन हाउ इट इज गोइंग टू इंपैक्ट इट सिमिलरली दिस विल बी एक्सप्लेन्ड इन द स्टेटमेंट ऑफ कैश फ्लोज आल्सो वी हैव जस्ट टुडे डिस्कस अबाउट द रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ डिसकंटिन्यूड ऑपरेशन एनी काइंड ऑफ प्रॉफिट और गेन और लॉस इज देयर फ्रॉम द डिसकंटिन्यूड ऑपरेशन इन द इनकम स्टेटमेंट सिमिलरली सच काइंड ऑफ reflection will be made in the statement of cash flows if some cash flows are occurring from that we must separately disclose its cash flow from operating activities from continued operation cash flow from operating activities from discontinued operation similarly cash flow from operating activities from activities from the investing activities from the continued operation or discontinued operation all these needs to be disclosed but under GAAP we were not doing so If some operation is treated as discontinued operation, we don't have any kind of investing and financing activities for that. Under GAAP, only operating activities are affected. But under the IFRS, if some kind of cash flows transaction are affecting it, they also must be disclosed in all the three segments of the cash flows in the statement of cash flows itself. That is the meaning of that paragraph.
Excuse me, sir.
जी जी
सर क्या आप ये पीपीटी ग्रुप में शेयर कर सकते हो
सारी आ जाएंगी आपको give me 2-3 days because some of the technical reason तुसी lectures भी तो पूरे नहीं मिले वो सारे दे सारे अपलोड हो जाएंगे ये भी गूगल ग्रुप पे तो गूगल जेड़ा फॉर क्लासरूम है उदे च भेज दिया
थैंक यू सर
नाउ वंस बिफोर वी एंड वन सर्वे